Second intermission presented by Huawei Smartphones with Nick, Kelly, and Elliot. It's 5-0 Vegas leading San Jose in game number one. And Nick,
well, defensively, how good are Vegas? And they were top 10 throughout the regular season and by far number one in these playoffs. And we talked in the first intermission, Ron, about man-on-man, something you don't see. And I just wanted to show how everybody early identifies who they have. That's McNabb on Kevin LeBlanc. Although he's given him 20, 30 feet, he's already identified that that's his man. You look at the guys underneath, there's Belmar, and he's got his man. Englund's got his man. McNabb, we've of course identified. And then there was a switch up top where Tuck and Noshik remained man on man. Look at the coverage in front of the net. Look at it. There is no room. And Fleury has a green light to see everything that comes from the outside. And then when they do double up, it's because you know you have a chance to get the puck out of your zone. I think it's just been fantastic job by Gerard Gallant, and it's continuing in the second round. We know how LA felt about it in the first, Kelly.
Awesome clips, Nick. It really showed it well. I always found that to be quite easy to defend that way if you have two things, smart players and really disciplined players. Because if you make one mistake, then you're in trouble. You start running around a little bit.
You're right. And you've got to stay calm, and then there has to be a level of trust and, of course, the communication, Ron. The old saying was, make your eyes, your ears.
Okay, so that leads us right into Marc-Andre Fleury and the communication he has with his teammates. In particular, Braden McNabb. It's going to start on the very first shift of the game. Easy save by Fleury, but McNabb is going to come in. You okay? Nice save. Good job. Here we go. Then you go to the second period. Here's where it gets a little bit more detailed. So the puck comes back to the point. The long shot. Now McNabb is picking an angle, and what he's doing is taking away the far post. You good? Okay. I take away the far post. You're short side. Okay. Later in the same period, go back to Derek Englund now in front. Take a look from this angle. The body positioning is perfect. Take away the far post. Fleury, short side. Awesome. That's great communication, great understanding about everybody's job. And then lastly, the long shot coming in. Fleury wanted to play this up. It's on the power play. Nate Schmidt, no, I want it. And now Fleury's going to motion to his teammate down the ice. Sorry, bud, but Nate wanted the easier, smarter play. Awesome stuff to watch. And you know what, Nick, with all the stuff you're showing and all these other plays, you can see why when they're in sync, they're really tough.
No question. And they're getting it from all four lines. And we know what the fourth line has meant to Gerard all season long. They haven't been rewarded with points. But you watch the first 5 minutes of this period, and you think that there's a situation where you rest on your laurels. Not a chance. This is Belmar, Noshik, and Carrier. And look at the back pressure. Carrier gets the puck, and where do they go? Right back on the forecheck again. You tell me you can watch this, and if we didn't have the score on the top of our screen, you would swear that Vegas was the team that was down 5-0 trying to get into a hockey game.
It's incredible. I mean, you're sitting here, you're watching this, and you're thinking, when does the clock strike 12? Like, when does Cinderella go back? But it doesn't look like it's going to happen.